Whether men roam free or savage each other when given their freedom, only God can say.
You seem to leave me no choice, Father.
My son, your city is at the frontier. Men like Columbus and Caboto are here to take advantage of that. You must go on that voyage to ensure that it is God's kingdom that is spread. God's kingdom.
Is there anything I can do for you?
No, thank you.
Do you like the captain?
What? Oh, yes, very colourful.
I thought I'd slip into something cool. Cotton feels so nice and soft against the skin. Don't you think?
Quite, yes.
Are you sure you don't want anything?
Yes.
Oh, you're nice and muscular, aren't you?
No, please, madam, I am on duty, you know.
Jeffries, look, be sensible about this. We can work something out.
How does it feel to sweat, eh? Not to have control?
It's only money we're talking about. Christ, it doesn't even belong to you!
Yes, but it won't be yours now either, will it?
Bloody hell! My heart! I got pills.
Carrots expensive.
I beg your pardon?
Carrots? Aren't they expensive?
Well, I don't really know.
Oh, yeah, cost a mint. You know, when I think of carrots, I think of my Uncle Fred. He had a very ruddy complexion, like a carrot. Dead now, poor soul. You know what his trouble was, don't you? He had too much sun.
Stayed out in the sun too much. Must run in the family.
Here. You any good at unblocking sinks?
Well, I suppose if...
My Uncle Fred was. Well, I mean, he was a plumber after all. Do you know, he built the biggest urinal in East Grinstead.
Did he really?
Oh, yeah. It was in all the papers and everything. Had his picture in the papers. Yeah. Mind, it was in black and white, so you couldn't see he looked like a carrot.
Naturally.
That urinal really captured the public's imagination. Day trippers came from miles around in coaches, brought packed lunches, so they could say they'd seen it. Well, and used it, of course.
Well, it's been very nice seeing you, but it's getting late and
I... Here, you would have liked his wife, my Auntie Daisy. She was always good for a laugh. She used to perform as a one-man band. Well, a one-woman band, really.
Look, you know,
she was good. She had a drum on her back, and cymbals between her knees, and a kazoo, and a harmonica there.
Look, I really must be going.
And it was tremendous. She was good.
Yes, I'm sure
she really was.
Was
good. Did you see the woman with a one-man band, drum on her back, and cymbals in her knees? She was really good. Everything was going.
The Alexander. The vessel cleared port here with 45 crew and reached Grenada with just 32. She carried 350 slaves and sold 342. She lost more crew than slaves.
I thought you said you came to Bristol to oppose the trade in slaves.
Yes.
Oh, whilst cruelly treated crews are a disgrace, it is not that...
You know that slave ships pay higher wages.
Yes.
The death rate among slavers' crews is much higher than for other trading voyages. In fact, higher even than for the slaves. The facts speak for themselves.
It is probably an injustice that should be addressed.
Mr. Carson does not consider that either the government, the parliament, or the wealthy will be interested in the fate of Africans.
Parliament would be more concerned with the fate and health of English seamen.
I'll be back. Same time next week.
Did I tell you I'm going to kill my wife?
What the hell do you think you ought to do? Look, let me out. I haven't got any money if this is a muggy. And I...
We have this friend, Mr. Simple.
Oh, Dimple.
Dimple.
He's always wanted to meet a private investigator. Isn't that right, Quentin?
Yes, that's right, Ashley.
So, we thought we would give him a little treat, didn't we, Quentin?
Yes, we did, Ashley.
Because you see, next week is his birthday, isn't it, Quentin?
Yes, Ashley.
So, we are going to give him a...
birthday treat.
Burn the rubber, Edward.
Stand the hazard of the die. I think there be 6 Richmonds in the field. 5 have I slain today instead of him. A horse! A horse! My kingdom for a horse!
Again, weren't you?
It must have been a nightmare.
Oh dear. Have a drinky, that'll make you feel better.
What?
There we go. Now it's your 3-minute call, so there's your crown, okay?
3 minutes? Oh God, help me. What's my first line?